The Word of God encourages us not to be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will take care of itself. Are you filled with doubts of what tomorrow will bring? Are you troubled and feeling hopeless about tomorrow? Receive God's word today of hope and assurance of a better tomorrow. You will be changed.
Good evening, everybody. I'm sure we have been enjoying the weekend. This is Tolu Okusanya reaching you again on tomorrow. Tomorrow is the Lord's day. Nothing must hinder us. Nothing will stop us from serving the Lord. Actually, every day belongs to Him, because every day is a gift from God unto us. And the writer of that scripture said, it is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, for His compassions do not fail. And that was Prophet Jeremiah who wrote that in Lamentations. It's of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, for His compassions never fail. His love is new every morning, and great is His faithfulness every day. So great is the faithfulness of the Lord every day, and for that we ought to serve Him and worship Him every day. Now, I want to share with us on something I've titled, What Have You Learned? What have you learned? Do you know we live to learn? We live to learn. So every day of our lives, we should learn. And we learn in order to live. So they're all interrelated. Both of them are related. You live in order to learn. And as you learn so that you can live better. So we live to learn and we learn to live. Romans 15 verse 4, what does it say? It says, for whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through the patience and comfort of scriptures might have hope. So the things that were written in the past were written for our learning. In other words, we learn from the past to prepare us in the now against the future. So we learn from the past to prepare us in the now for the future. So the past, the present, and the future are all linked together. What have you learned? When 2020 started, the year 2020, most of us did not know that there was going to be a pandemic. Most of us did not foresee a situation where we'll not even be able to come to church. Talk less of going about our businesses and going to school and so on. But then the pandemic struck. It happened since 2019. That's why it's called COVID-19. But then look at where we are today. See businesses that have been affected. See the lives that have been lost. See the families that have been displaced. See projections that have been thrown overboard. What have we learned in all of this? One of the things we should have learned is this, is that God alone is in control, that man is not in control. Another lesson we should have learned is this, that science is not final, that science has a limitation, that science can fail. Another thing we should learn is that life is a gift from God to us. We can lose life if we're not careful. You could be here today and you may not be there tomorrow. Another lesson about life is this, that we should learn, is this. We must live with eternity in view. We must be prepared for eternity every day of our lives. I hope we have learned these lessons, and I hope we're still learning. One important lesson that we should take note of is this. We must plan with adaptation in mind. Never be boxed in a corner, or never be fixed in your ways. Don't be set as you make your plans, because this is the reality of the times in which we are right now. So as you do your plans, can you be ready to incorporate adaptation into your plans so that when things change, you can adapt? Now, God can never be taken by surprise, but man can be taken by surprise, like we have seen in this issue of the COVID-19. Remember Genesis chapter 30 and verse 27 there. This was Laban addressing his nephew, Jacob, and he said, I have learned by experience that God has blessed me for your sake. So we learn from the past. Have we learned from the past? And are we still learning even now? Because nothing now is permanent. Only God is permanent. So this tells us we're to draw closer to God, we're to abound in doing His will, we're to live with eternity in view, and we're to live as though each day was our last. Don't postpone living. Come to Christ today and enjoy His fullness. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
We believe you have been blessed. Join us at 9 a.m. tomorrow at Vinebrand Church, Queen School Road, Akpata, GRA, for a life-changing experience in our glorious worship service. We are confident that with Jesus, your tomorrow will be better than today. Come thou with us and we will do thee good. God bless you.